Hi, my name is Kato Shiganaku and I'm the product manager for Vision AI. And in this video, we will show you how to create and run a very simple test case using Vision AI. In this video, you will also see how we're able to keep up with technology changes and execute your automation even behind hard to access environments like Citrix or virtual desktop environments. So to start off, we will start our demonstration with a mockup. This is a mockup of an application that we want to automate. Let's assume the designers have given this to the testing department as well as the development department. So while the developers are starting to develop the application, the testers can already start scanning this application and creating a module using Tricentis Tosca. Vision AI is fully integrated into our Tricentis Tosca solution. So therefore, you can use Tosca as usual to perform the scan. Here you select Vision AI as your scanning engine, and after that, everything feels and looks the same as it does when you use any other type of Tricentis Tosca engine. So here you see how you can select all the different elements on the screen. By just hovering over them, they are already recognized and you can build your module. If you look to the technical properties of this, you will see that we are now using the typical visual properties like the control type, which in this case is an input. It could also be a dropdown, a table, and so on, many more. You can also specify the label. So in this case, we would look for a control, which is an input that is associated to a label that says annual mileage. All of this only works on the visual representation on the screen and does not need any connection to the technology and the underlying tech layer. So as a next step, when we have our finished module, can now create our test case in Tosca like we always do. So again, we open that module that we just created, drag it into our test case section, and insert all the data as needed for our test case. As a next step, we can now run this test case. And we will run it first against that PDF mockup. And as you can see, the test is already running. As it is only using the visual clues, our tests can identify the right elements and try to steer them, which is what we're doing here in this test case. And what we're seeing is that we don't need any connection to the underlying technology. The application is really already automatable by just looking at the visual clues. So as the next step, the finished application comes over. And to make things a bit more complex, it is available behind a remote desktop connection. So here we open a remote desktop connection and open the finished application. And now we just run the same test case that we created towards the mockup, and we can see how easily it also works against the finished.NET application. And to even go a step ahead, we now run the same test case in the web. So this is again the same application, but now written for the web. And we can run the same test case and it will also work on the finished web application. So here you would have to write automation for the old .NET application, you would have to write automation for the new web application, and you would have a lot of difficulties historically to really access the application behind the remote desktop connection. As you could see with Vision AI, all of this can be overcome very easily. To see how Vision AI can simply deal with controls where historically you would need a lot of customizations, please join our next video.